In today's video, we have to survive for 100 days in Jurassic Park. We have three objectives. First, craft full adamantine armor. Second, hunt and kill a Tyrannosaurus Rex. And our last objective, defeat the mad scientists who genetically resurrected and cloned the dinosaurs, unleashing them into the world.
Climate angle 2.5.
Copy, I'm Popeye.
Traffic 1 mile, 12 o'clock.
Copy. Visual that traffic. Kilo on top.
All right, cadets. This is a top secret mission. We're dispatching both of you to Black Site 747. Sergeant Ace and Lieutenant Rasher went missing in action 3 months ago. Your missions are to rescue Ace and Rasher and investigate the rumors of the raging scientist. Best of luck, cadets. Godspeed.
Wow, it's a beautiful day outside. The sun is out and the sky is blue. You can't ask for anything better than this. 10-4, looks like we're gonna have clear skies for the rest of the day. Now approaching the target destination, over. Whoa, what's going on? Mayday, we're going down! My head. What happened? I'm alive? Painful, do your read, over. No response. I guess we gotta take it from here.
And so our journey began. I started immediately on gathering the materials necessary to get herself tools. Losing communication with Painful was not gonna make things any easier. After getting herself stone tools and some food, I stumbled upon what looked to be a tent. There was a villager that traded fossils. We didn't have any emeralds, so we continued and got the wool from the tent, and stole the bed. After leaving the tent, I ran into what looked like some prehistoric alligators. Luckily, they didn't notice me. When I looked down from on top of the hill, I noticed my first dinosaurs. I went down the hill and decided to go through the plains. There were some moose, and lucky for me, all these dinosaurs were neutral. I passed by some elephants and some triceratops. I then gathered up some wood and picked some berries. I then spotted what looked to be like another tent. And it was, and this time there was a chest with an iron pickaxe. We went into a nearby cave and started mining some coal, blocked up both sides of the tent, got ourselves some torches, and then went to bed. On day 4, we went back into the mines, killed a spider, mined some iron, mined some tin, and nearly fell into a ravine. Thank goodness I wasn't standing on that block. And on day 5, we went back to the surface and started looking for a suitable spot to set up a base. We had to travel extremely carefully as there was dinosaurs everywhere. After about 3 days of travel, we made it to a jungle biome. I noticed some bird-like dinosaurs, so I carefully approached the jungle biome. I wasn't sure if they were going to attack me, so I decided to lay low. I quickly ran on top of a tree, but it looked like the dinosaurs weren't going to attack. I then decided I may as well make a treehouse. So I went to sleep and began building the treehouse. The treehouse should keep me pretty safe as I was high up from the ground, so no dinosaurs could sneak up on me while I was sleeping. On day 10, we decided to go mining, got ourselves some iron, got a full set of iron armor, and found our first diamonds in a crystal cave. There was also lots of gold and redstone. While returning to the surface, we ended up running into an alligator guard, which surprisingly wasn't difficult to kill. On day 12, I returned back to base and deposited all my materials. On day 13, I spotted what looked to be like an ocelot, so I crafted a fishing rod, fished up a couple fish, and after luring it over with a fish, I now have my very own pet cat. I think I'm gonna give this guy the name Tim Bob. So I sat Tim Bob up in the treehouse, and for the next 2 days, I began working on expanding the treehouse, creating myself some farms, and from days 16 to 17, we walled off our base to protect us from hostile creatures. After completing the build, I looked over everything, and the base is really starting to come along well. On day 18, we crafted ourselves a diamond pick, and went back down into the caves to find ourselves a lava pool. We mined enough obsidian to make another portal back at our base, and on day 19, we decided to go into the nether. I set up a pillar next to my portal, and began my journey looking for another fortress. I grabbed some glowstone along the way, and after 4 long days of searching, I finally found myself a nether fortress. So I pillared up, mined into the fortress, and immediately got attacked by a nether wolf. It hit me off, and it took a ton of fall damage. If it weren't for the shield, I probably would have died. That was a close call. The nether wolves also dropped blaze powder, which is pretty nice. I finally made my way into the fortress, took out another nether wolf. The first hallway I walked down had a blaze spawner at the end, so I started farming as many blazes as I could, but realized I was running low on food. I wanted to get at least half a dozen blaze rods before I was out of here though. So after killing a few more blazes, I explored a little bit of the fortress and found myself a velociraptor skull and some horse armor. From days 24 to 25, we traveled back to our nether portal. When I came out the other side, I heard my cat taking damage. I was kind of confused at first, but I quickly ran up the stairs, climbed up the ladder as fast as I could, and realized someone was burning down my base. He had a lab coat on. It must have been the mad scientist. He enderpearled up to what looked to be a helicopter, and I placed down water to try and stop the fire. I tried pillaring up to him as quickly as I could, but but I just wasn't fast enough. He was already in his helicopter taking off. He could have just burnt down my base, but he killed my cat Tim Bob. Now things were personal. I tried putting out as many fires as I could, nearly died in the process. Even though the treehouse protected me really well against dinosaurs, it didn't do such a good job against fire. After putting out the fire for the rest of the day, now that the mad scientist knew where I lived, I decided to relocate my base and left a sign for any survivors that might come across my base. From days 26 to 28, we began our search for a new base location. That was until I saw some sort of structure in the distance, and it ended up being a crashed plane. I was a little confused at first, but things started to add up. Sergeant Ace and Lieutenant Rashner went missing 3 months ago, and it was reported that their aircraft had to crash land. The mad scientist must have had a role in all of this. While all these thoughts were flooding my head, I ended up finding some iron blocks and adamantine blocks in the back of the aircraft. After mining all the blocks, I went to the front of the aircraft to inspect it. Everything just looked overgrown and there was no sign of life. I decided to leave the aircraft and continue my search for a suitable spot for my base. After a few days of searching, I gave up and decided to be a cave junkie. With the adamantine I found, I crafted a chestplate, leggings, and a saber. And on day 33, I decided I should go mining for a while. I mined all kinds of ores and found myself an ice cave. I found some lava, turned it into obsidian, and mined enough for an enchantment table. I also found myself an archaeologist underground. He didn't really offer too many good trades, so I continued mining and found gold, and finally managed to find some diamonds. There was only two in this vein, but shortly after, I found another two diamonds. Afterwards, I mined some lapis and then headed back to base. I crafted up my enchantment table and used the rest of my diamonds for a diamond helmet and boots. After enchanting all my armor and weapon, I spent the rest of day 39 to 40 gathering up wood, getting food from some animals, and gathering apples from tree leaves. After getting a couple apples, I started heading home. I ended up running into a prehistoric alligator and tried to fight it, and for some reason, this one was pretty easy to kill. It gave me a false sense of confidence, so I challenged another alligator, but this one knocked me into the water. And you know what they say about fighting an alligator in the water. I was doing the best to block the hits with my shield, but every time I went for a hit, it just kept knocking me back out of range. So I pillared up and played it as carefully as I could and ended up taking out the alligator. I ended up fighting one more on the way back just to see if I could kill it, but I was taking way too much damage and there was a ton of mobs around me, so I decided to make a run for it back to base. After taking a good night's rest, I went out on day 41 to gather some sand for some glass. I wanted to prepare for taking out a Tyrannosaurus Rex, so I made some glass bottles and started on brewing. I brewed myself strength 2 potions, speed 2 potions, and made a couple of golden apples. So on day 43, I set out to go look for a Tyrannosaurus Rex. I found a Stegosaurus on the way, and even a pterodactyl. After a lot more traveling, I stumbled upon a biome with some really large trees. And then I heard what sounded like a deep growl. I couldn't see what it was at first, but when I got closer, it was clearly a T-Rex. So I drank my potions of speed and strength, and went to attack the smaller T-Rex first. I decided to try and get behind the T-Rex, and after a few hits with my adamantine saber, the first T-Rex fell. I looked over at the second T-Rex, and this one was a lot larger. I still decided to go straight in for him, and took a pretty big hit. After attacking him from behind a few times, I started to get pretty low, so I backed up and ate a golden apple. I needed to use the trees to my advantage as best as possible. So from behind the tree, I landed a few hits, but at the same time, the T-Rex did a lot of damage, so I backed up to eat another golden apple. I went in to try and finish him off, and after one more hit, I defeated the giant T-Rex. Afterwards, I went for the smaller T-Rex, and took that one out pretty easily. This adamantine saber served me really well. So after collecting the T-Rex's skull, I spent the next 3 days traveling back to my base. Once I returned back to base, I decided I want to make a little display case for this T-Rex skull, which I thought turned out pretty good. From days 55 to 58, I went back out to explore. I ended up finding a dinosaur egg, which I'm pretty sure belonged to this dinosaur. After watching it for a bit, the egg started to shake. And when I looked away for a second, the egg hatched. It looked just like the other dinosaur. I tried feeding it some seeds to see if I could tame it, but I ended up just eating all my seeds. Probably should have expected that from my dinosaur. So I continued exploring and found myself a desert temple, which had some nice goodies inside, including an enchanted book, golden apples, and some emeralds. I then found myself a desert village and decided to borrow all their crops. After a little more exploring, I ran into some dodo birds, and it looked like one of them had laid an egg. So I right-clicked the egg, and out came a baby dodo bird. I needed a way to lead this to base, so I found a villager tent, stole the lead from the horse, and led my baby dodo bird all the way back to my cave base. Make sure to leave a comment of what you think we should name this little guy. I then decided it was time to commemorate Tim Bob the cat, so I made a little memorial for him. From days 59 to 63, I decided to explore the alpine biomes. I ended up running into a huge herd of mammoths, and they started to attack me for some reason. The mammoths do a decent amount of damage and knock you back pretty far, but with my shield and saber, I was able to handle them pretty easily. Once I got past the herd of mammoths, I looked up and saw what looked to be some floating blocks. I went to take a closer look, and it looked like some sort of abandoned base. I wonder what the heck happened here. There were farms, but there was no chests or anything else. So I harvested some of the crops and continued journeying for the next 3 days. I ended up finding a village and found some strange building I've never seen in a village before. It looked like some sort of laboratory. There were all sorts of DNA machines machines and a mushroom cow in the back. There was a chest behind the counter with a ton of test tubes and syringes. I then found a strange item called the Scarab Gem, took it out, and got an achievement for it. I wasn't sure what it was used for at first, but after some research, turns out you can use this to tame dinosaurs. I then stole some of the books from the village and continued on my journey. I ended up seeing a dinosaur known as an Allosaurus, basically a mini T-Rex. So I drank my potions and decided to take it on. I began the fight by attacking him and bringing him over to the water. I knew I wouldn't be able to outrun this dinosaur on land, so I knew I needed some sort of terrain advantage. Using the water to my advantage, I got him into a weakened state and used the Scarab Gem to tame it, and I now have my very own Allosaurus. Now that I had the Allosaurus tamed, I needed some way to command him. So I headed back to base, crafted myself a skull stick, and used the skull stick to command my Allosaurus to follow me. I then waited for it to be night and killed a few spiders so I could make myself a whip. I could then use my whip to ride my Allosaurus like it was a horse, except it was a lot faster than a horse. I got a little lost while going back to base at night and ended up finding a trail of torches. I then followed the torches for a few hundred blocks and found what looked like to be an active base. Parked my Allosaurus outside and went inside to investigate to see if anybody was home. The base was built into the side of a mesobiome hill. It seemed like a pretty normal base, but nobody was home. I wasn't sure who the base belonged to. I ended up coming up with a plan and left a sign asking if they could meet me at a set of coordinates that led to the plane crash site. I ended up returning back to my base first so I could prepare myself for meeting up with this person. I ended up tying up my Allosaurus and leaving him at my base as I didn't want him to attack whoever I was meeting up with. So I began my journey back to the plane crash site. On the way there, I ended up fighting some rhinoceros. They didn't do too much damage, but when they hit you, they knocked you back really far. After defeating the rhinoceros and traveling for a few more days, I finally made it to the plane crash site. I pillared up to get on top of the plane and waited for someone to arrive.
Whoa, was that? Painful, is that you? 10-4, glad to see you're still alive, Forrest. I ended up losing control and crash landed. Did you land safely?
No, my engine cut off too. I wonder if there was some sort of energy barrier that cut off our power.
I'm not sure, but this plane must be where Rasher and Ace crash landed. I hope they're both still alive.
Wait, what is that noise?
What the heck? That's the mad scientist! Follow him quick!
And so the chase began. What was the mad scientist up to? Is this just a coincidence? We followed the path his helicopter took for the next 4 days, and we ended up finding an entrance to a suspicious cavern. Was this an entrance to the mad scientist's lair? We had nothing to lose, and we needed to find Ace and Rasher. So we entered this eerie-looking cave. The first part of the cave was lit up, but further in, it was completely pitch black. I let Painful lead the way on this one. This cave went up for a while and had many twists and turns, so for the next 2 days, we made our way through the cavern. On day 87, it looked like we had reached the end point of the cavern. We also heard some strange dinosaur noises, and when we entered the room, we found Ace and Rasher. There were even velociraptors in the other cells. We both let out Ace and Rasher so they could escape and so that we could investigate the room.
Where's the mad scientist? Whoa, watch out, it's a trap!
We were blocked into the room, and the velociraptors were let out. We quickly took out the velociraptors, and once we took out both velociraptors, we knew we needed to get out of the room. So we started working on breaking our way out, and all of a sudden we were both poisoned. We looked behind us, and the mad scientist was there. This was it. This was the final battle. If we didn't defeat the mad scientist here, Ace and Rasher would be left for dead. We started to attack the mad scientist, who for some reason had absolutely no armor. After countless hits, he still wasn't taking much damage. He must have been using some special kinds of potions. Luckily, we brought some of our own potions, and Painful used them to heal us. This poison was really annoying, though, and I needed to eat food as much as I could. The mad scientist was even using instant damage potions. We did not want to get hit by too many of those. I went in for another hit, but took a ton of damage, getting down to 1 heart. Luckily, Painful splashed me with some instant health, and I went in to get another hit. I then disengaged to drink my strength and speed potions. After I drank my potions, Painful had backed him into a corner. We both double-teamed the scientist and pushed him into the lava, and watched as the mad scientist burned in the lava. We had done it. We had finally gotten rid of the mad scientist. We noticed that there was some icy stone in the wall, and we broke down the icy stone and realized this must have been where he was hiding. There was all sorts of brewing stands, computers. That could have been how he shut off the power of our helicopters. Afterwards, we broke down the gravel, meeting back up with Ace and Rasher. Luckily, they were okay. We also ended up finding the mad scientist's secret escape route. First, it just seemed like a normal cave, but we ended up finding an extremely long tunnel. So we followed this pathway for 7 days. This pathway was extremely long. We finally reached the end of the secret passageway with barely any food to spare. So we climbed the ladder, and once we reached the surface, we looked behind us and saw his helicopter perched on top of a building. It makes sense that he'd want to hide his helicopter far away from his actual base. So we all loaded up into the helicopter, with Painful as the pilot. We're gonna need to restock on food and supplies. So after about 3 days of traveling by helicopter, we made it back to Painful's base. So we gave Ace and Rasher full iron armor and replenished our food. So on day 100, we all got back in the helicopter and made our way back to the battleship. And Painful stuck the landing. Also, once we got out, me and Painful Painful noticed that Ace had fell asleep in the back. If you made it this far in the video, make sure to watch Painful's video as well. We each had different objectives, which made our videos a lot different from each other. Make sure to show his video some love, and thanks so much for watching. Take care, everyone.